Hey guys, it's Foster School 1, and last night when I checked, I got over 1,000 views on my how to build Lego Portal 2 Lego stuff or whatever I call it. I forget. Sorry, I know, kind of lame. Oh my god. Okay, anyways, so I'm gonna show you how to make a few things today. So first off, I'm gonna show you how to make Peabody. Minifigure size, though, obviously, otherwise it'd be much bigger. So first, you start with these two pieces, right there. And then you take one of these pieces, right there, so that way you can have a hinge. So put these two under there, like that. And then you take a single stud like that, white stud like that, and please ignore any background talking or anything, that's my niece and my exchange student brother. Anyways, so, and then you take a cone piece like this, put it on top. Obviously, as you can see, there's more parts, so this isn't the entire thing. So, you take this, and you make two of these. Then you take a three long piece, put it the middle one on top of him, and then put it like this. This is for mainly stop motion videos. If you're looking for, you know, oh, it looks so cool kind of thing, this is not the model for you. I mean, maybe it's a little cool, but I just thought of it, so not trying to brag, but yeah, anyways. So that was awkward. Anyways, so this is Peabody for, you know, like, interacting with minifigs and such, because if you look at closely in the game, there he's not that much bigger than Shell. Anyways, so now onto Peabody. So first you're going to need these pieces, and you're going to take a stub piece kind of thing where it has a stub on the front. You're going to take a transparent blue stub, and then you're going to take a three-piece, put it on his back, like this, so far, in case you didn't see what I was running earlier. Anyways, so then you take a black single stud thing, like that, then put this on the bottom, like that, then take, just like Peabody, bottom, two of these. Obviously, as everyone knows, Peabody and Atlas are not the same because they have a very different body structure. So then you have these, take two black 2x2s like that. Then take the angle pieces, then put them like that. Again, this is really just for minifig use, interaction with minifigs. Because if you're just trying to make something that looks cool to show off, then that's not really it. I mean, unless you're trying to show off at, like, some, you know, mini thing where you have to make stop motion. Anyways. Okay, next up is the energy ball thing. If anyone knows what it's really called, leave it in the comments below. Anyways, so put four levers. Sorry about the mismatching. Black lever, because, well, actually, they should all be black levers, not red levers, but these were all the levers I could find. Sorry, I really have to get more pieces. Sorry. Anyway, so then you take a 2x4 flat with a stud piece in the middle, put that in the middle of your 4x4, and then make a, before that, then take a gray one of these, then make a tower of see-through-ish pieces. I put a yellow one at the end because then you attach it to the yellow one and it looks like there's kind of a drag behind. I don't really know. Tell me if that actually looks good. Leave in the comments below. Anyways, so then that's that. You can extend the see-through part as it gets farther away for stop motion videos. Now, my simplest models are, where'd that stupid button go? There it is. Sorry about that. The button that stands up. It's just a three-piece model. Just these two. Put them on top of each other. Then red piece on top. Button. One little button. Sorry about that. That's true. Then potato gladdos. Just take another one of the kind of like the pieces you use to make that main piece that Atlas's eye is on. One of these. Take a yellow piece. Put it on top. If you want, you can do a white one on a transparent yellow one. I don't really like the look of it. So there's potato gladdos. The cake. Again, simple two-piece. Just a brown circle thing with four studs on top. Then just take a white piece and shove it in the middle. Okay, and then another more complicated one. Aerial faceplate. Now, you start off with a hinge. Now, you have to be careful with this one because I made the mistake several times when trying to build this of putting it on like this. You have to put it on like this, otherwise it won't look good because of the fact, not for aesthetics, but see, this is the only way it will move like that, but if you put it on backwards by accident, which I did a ton, it will move down, so that's why you have to put it on the right way. Just a second. Sorry, I'm messing up again. Anyways, so then you take a 4x4, I mean a 2x2, sorry, and then a flat 2x2, then take a flat blue 1x2, put there, aerial face. Now this one's a really, really complicated build. You don't have to do it exactly like I did, but this is just how I did it, the incinerator. So let me get this out of the way. So you take a black space like this. It has 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. An 8x8 bottom piece. Then you take a red 4x4. Place that in the very middle. You'll see why I'm putting that there later. Okay, then take a 6 long piece. And basically, I didn't have enough that were exactly that length, so I kind of had to make it so it would, like, only pieces that would fit like that. So sorry about any little duba things. So then build it together. This one's going to start being weird, so... Basically, it's basically this, except put one of these in the back, because that will elevate it a little bit, because if you look at it closely, it has a slight elevation to it at the back end. So, then you take... So, then you take these... I know, I'm really doing it the hard way. I should have just ordered some, but LLD is down. But I'm really, really kind of mad that they did that, in all honesty, because of the fact that now I can't really order anything, which would be so much easier than just having to build all this by hand. But anyways, so then you just put a few random pieces inside of this however you like. So, you know, some little things, little flame elements. You can just put regular flames if you have access to them, but I don't even know if they're on the, like, regular brand anymore. I remember there were a few Power Ranger sets that had, you know, like, it was like the base of a stud or a circle, and it had fire on it. Okay, so anyways, you take one of these, two of these, actually, put that there. And put that one. Sorry about that. Okay, anyways, and then there you go. One incinerator. And that's pretty much it for that one. So, no question. Okay, anyways, so here are pretty much all the Lego Portal things I've made. And if you can't tell, The current is not a lie. There's the energy projector thing. Incinerator, turret, the button. Atlas Peabody, potato GLaDOS, regular GLaDOS, Wheatley core, the Wheatley core, turret, button next to the incinerator, and of course, shell. I know, why did I just do that voice? New frequency. Anyways. So yeah, that's all of them. And of course, fate. Alright, thanks for watching. Rate and subscribe. And leave anything else you want me to build in the comments below. Bye!